Falling in love is easy. It's the crawling out of it. That's the hard part. Rejection tastes metallic, like putting a coin in your mouth. Even after taking it out of your mouth, the rejection is still... The coin is... Well, never mind. Rejection actually tastes a lot sweeter. And has yellow number 5. Oh, and xanthan gum. Seven weeks after Lauren. It seemed like time for a new crush. Bowling pins always get back up, right? And sometimes they're not toppled. Most of the time, yes, but not always. It's easy to fall back into old habits. How could I not when I saw her? She held her fork with such poise. The way she dabbed her napkin on her lips. How could I not fall? How could I ever approach her? I've had my problems in the past, and face-to-face confrontation was no longer my preferred method. She went to the lunchroom every day at exactly 1:35. That was the time I chose to strike. But how was I to express the feelings welled up inside? Feelings so powerful that I've only felt them 3 or 4 times before. At least that's as many as I can remember. Maybe 5 times. Forget it, it doesn't matter. Powerful feelings, that's the point. Then, all of a sudden it hit me. The perfect means for expression were right under my nose. In my mouth, actually. I tried not to panic as I brought my plan to fruition. It was perfect. Communication through confectionery. It was so easy. I wouldn't have to talk to her at all. It seemed that I would know how she felt about me in mere moments. Well, things didn't work out quite as I'd have hoped. A little confusion. She didn't know not to eat them both, but it was okay. Nothing that a few days of isolation in my room couldn't fix. And as I stared at my white ceiling through tear-filled eyes, I thought out my next plan. It was easy. All I needed to do was give her a little more information. I figured she couldn't be confused. It was all there spelled out to her. Literally. About 20 minutes later, she finished the last page. My heart was throbbing. Thank you. It all seemed so clear. And then, only then did it hit me. She ate the one that said yes. That was a good thing, right? But wait, she also left the one that said no. That was bad, right?
No! Failure or jubilation? How could I experience both at the same time? I panicked.
Lucky for me, I was able to stealthily get away unnoticed. Two weeks alone. It really hit the spot. I even started to hold down food again, but I still couldn't get my love out of my mind. I wasn't ready to give up yet, but what else could I try? I heard a story once that told of finding the perfect conversation heart. Legend has it that if you look through enough candy hearts, you'll find the one that expresses your feelings exactly in a way that you never could otherwise. Everyone has their own perfect heart, but most never find them. It was a long shot, but I swore to myself that if it existed, I was going to find it. Therefore, in a way, it was a blessing for me to have missed Valentine's Day. All of the candy hearts were 75% off, and I had to buy a lot of them. It took some searching. A lot of searching. It was a little hard to read, and by then it was early April. But I found it. I found it. It was time. I knew I had to do it. I had the heart that said it all. How could she say no? It was like someone had taken my heart, put it in their mouth, and crushed it. Yeah, it was really just like that. Exactly. And that is the last thing I can remember. Until now, I guess. How long had I been unconscious? I think it's already dinner time. No one seems to have come to my aid. I'm cold, but at least I'm in love.